Hi everyone, this is Carolyn with MyoFit. I want to talk to you today in a time of social and physical distancing where we're spending a lot of time at home, some strategies for potentially you're working in an office space or you're sitting a lot at home, again, looking at a computer, as well as maybe lounging on the couch and watching Netflix, movies, things like that. Today we're going to talk about some strategies and how we can make you more comfortable, but also protect your body in these times. So today I first want to talk about some different positions that you might be in sitting on the couch. This is a great example of a position that potentially could cause us a lot of pain, especially if we're spending a lot of time in it. So as a general rule, something I want you guys to think about is keeping your spine in a neutral position. And so to do that, in terms of him sitting here playing on his phone, watching TV, I am today going to give him a bolster. He's going to put it just in his lumbar spine, tuck it down kind of close to your butt, so that we protect our low back. It puts us into a little bit of a better position and makes it easier for us to sit upright, particularly sit upright comfortably. This can be a great option for a lot of time in a seated position. So for the second position today, a lot of times we want to be laying on the couch, lounging, watching TV, those types of things to decompress. Again, we want to keep the spine in a neutral position. And so some ways that we can do that, this couch is a little bit tricky because it's small and Darren is taller than the couch is. And so if we were looking at his cervical spine, his neck, we want to get a pillow that essentially is going to cover the space between his shoulder and his ear so that he can keep his neck into a neutral spine. How we can also help his lumbar spine and down into his hips is he can take a pillow or a bolster, again, put that in between his knees, and that's going to help keep him from rotating too far in any one direction, again, which is a position that if you lay or sit in that position for a long amount of time can end up causing people a lot of pain. So the next thing that I want to talk about today is a little bit of some office ergonomics, especially because a lot of people are working from home. We're working in an environment that we're potentially unfamiliar with. There's a lot of distractions, things like that. And so this can oftentimes be a position that we're working in. A lot of times it comes from a very good place. People are trying to get comfortable and do the best they can. So a few tips that we can have would be to center his computer. So he's going to put it on his lap. Laptops are very tricky in general, and I'm going to talk through a few of the reasons why, because I know people use laptops. And so, again, we're going to keep the spine in neutral. He could even, if he had low back pain, potentially put, like we talked about earlier in the video, a lumbar pillow, a bolster, something behind his low back. He's going to keep his head up and his chin forward. So the trick with this is if he's sitting in this position in a laptop, he's not able to see his screen. And so if you're able to work from a monitor, a desktop, that's even better. You want your eyes to be at the top one third of the screen. That's gonna help you keep good posture, keep your neck in a neutral position. Yes, so he would have to elevate a little bit. There's different tricks that we can do for that. Some of them could be putting some textbooks, things like that, reams of paper, whatever you may have at home to improvise and be a little bit creative in terms of elevating his laptop and elevating his workspace. The other simple thing I want to talk about and trick is to think about the 90-90-90 rule. And so with that, his elbows should be at a 90 degree angle, his hips should be at a 90 degree angle, and then his knees should also be at a 90 degree angle. There's a lot of versatility with this. That 90-90-90 rule is not absolutely perfect for everyone, but it's a really fantastic starting place for you to consider and think about and work through what kind of changes you may have to make with that.